This video is an example of finding a confidence interval for a population mean when sigma is known. A professor wants to estimate how many hours per week her students study. A simple random sample of 74 students had a mean of 20 hours of studying per week. Construct a 99% confidence interval for the mean number of hours students studies per week. Assume that the population standard deviation is known to be 3.5 hours per week. So I want to construct a confidence interval for the population mean mu, and I have two choices. If sigma is known, I'm going to use the z-distribution. If sigma is unknown, I'm going to use the t-distribution. If I know that the original population is normally distributed. But in this case, I'm going to use the z-distribution because we are told to assume that we know the population standard deviation. So the pieces that I need will be the sample size, 74 students, and the sample mean was 20. And again, the population standard deviation is known to be 3.5. They are asking for a 99% level of confidence. Okay, so my CI level, 99%. So the corresponding alpha level, which I will have to divide in half, is going to be 0.01. Okay, so if the confidence level is 0.99, then alpha is 0.01. Now for a confidence interval, you have to divide this in half to get the tail area. Okay, so the formula for the confidence interval for the mean when sigma is known, oops, sorry, I'm out of lead. Hold on just one second. Sorry about that. Is x bar plus or minus this critical value z sub alpha over 2. Okay, so I'm looking for a z score, and this alpha over 2 is going to tell me how much area I want in that tail, times the population standard deviation divided by the square root of n. Okay, so the only piece I don't have given to me is this z sub alpha over 2. So briefly, if you were to do all of this by hand, well, I'm going to sort of do this by hand. I'm going to find the critical value using my inverse normal function in my calculator, and then I'll go back and I'll find the entire confidence interval using the z interval function in the TI-84. Okay, so just finding this piece by itself, this critical value, z sub alpha over 2, is pretty straightforward, but it is helpful to sketch what's given so that you know exactly what you're looking for. So if my level of confidence is 0.99, that means I want 0.99 amount of area between these two upper tails. So this lower one will be negative z sub alpha over 2, and this upper one will be positive z sub alpha over 2. They will be symmetric. So I only need the positive one to input into the formula, but I'm going to find the lower one first. You could find the upper one first, but you'd have to keep in mind that the inverse normal function on the calculator is expecting a cumulative area for the input. So you can't put in an area of 0.99. Okay, so if there's 0.99 amount of area between these two tails, there's 0.01 left over together in those tails. So one tail will have 0.005. amount of area. Okay, so I'm going to go to my inverse normal function. So that's under my distribution menu, option 3. And the cumulative area is 0.005. I forgot this. I have a newer calculator, and you can put in that center area. On the older TI-84s, you need to put in this cumulative area of 0.005. I'm going to leave mu and sigma as is because I'm working with standard normal. And that 0.005 is in this left tail. So I get a lower z-score of negative 2.576. So this makes this upper one, the one that I input into the formula, positive 2.576. Let me go briefly back to that inverse normal screen. Again, I forgot this is a newer TI-84. The older ones don't have these three options. The older TI-84s just read that left tail. So if I wanted to put input as in between, I could put in 0.99 and make that my center. And it gives me those two values, negative 2.576 and positive 2.576, and this is the one you want for the formula. Going back to that distribution menu, inverse normal, if I wanted to find this upper one by itself, I'd have to put in a cumulative area of 0.995, because it's not just 0.99 to the left of it, it's 0.99 plus this 0.05 more. So I could do that. I could put in 0.995 and select right. Oops, sorry, I had that reversed. That should be, I'm so used to my old calculator that, there we go, that I'm getting the sides I'm on switched. All right, so putting in left, my mistake, okay, it's going to give me that positive value. So I want 0.995 amount of area to the left of that, okay, and that's going to give me this positive critical value. Okay, and you're also always welcome to read your table backwards, your z-table, find the area in the body of the table and read outward, but that sometimes isn't quite as accurate as using your calculator. So inputting the pieces, the formula will be 20 plus or minus 2.576 times 3.5 over the square root of 74. Okay, so inputting that into the calculator, I'll do this part first. This is the margin of error. It's going to be 20 plus or minus 2.576 times 3.5 divided by the square root of 74. All right, so the margin of error is 1.048. Now I've done some rounding in between here. I've rounded my critical value and I'm also rounding my margin of error. So my final answer might be slightly off from what I need to input into the homework system that I'm using. Okay, so I will go back and show you how to get the confidence interval directly from the calculator. So I want to subtract that margin of error to get the lower endpoint. Okay, so that lower endpoint will be 18.952. And then the upper endpoint will be 21.048. Okay, and that's going to be a 99% confidence interval for mu. To get it from the calculator directly, you want to go to your stat menu, right arrow over to tests, and choose number 7, which is the Z interval. Okay, it's the confidence interval for the mean when sigma is known. The Z indicates we're using the Z distribution for that critical value. You could either have the raw data in a list. In other words, I could have all 74 values in a list, and then I would use this option here, or you have the summary statistics, which is what I have. So I'm going to select that. It's going to ask for sigma, which I forgot what it was. It's 3.5. And the sample mean was 20. My sample size was 74. And my level of confidence is 0.99. You can change that if you need. Okay, so the rounding rounding in between didn't seem to have that much of an issue with this confidence interval. I get the same thing. Okay, so if you don't need to find the margin of error separately, or you just want to go right to the confidence interval, you could use the calculator's built-in Z interval function.